John Alzheimer is known as one of our nation's most recognized credit experts. Having worked for 28 years in the credit industry, John has become one of the most prolific speakers about credit and the go-to authority on answers to credit-related questions. Credit Countdown with John Alzheimer.
Hello, my name is John Alzheimer. I am a consumer credit expert with almost 30 years of experience in the credit industry. I've spent time at FICO, which is the company behind the FICO credit scoring system, and Equifax, which is one of the three generally recognized credit reporting agencies. So today I'm going to talk about, it's one of the common questions that I get from time to time about, you know, the value of closing credit cards in your credit score and some of the dangers with respect to closing credit scores. I think it's pretty commonly known if you follow any of the credit-related blogosphere that closing credit cards can possibly lower your scores. What is unfortunate is that there's a lot of incorrect information floating around. And so I'm going to clarify the issue today, and we'll talk a little bit about the upside and the downside of closing credit cards. Why would you choose to close a credit card? You know, the annual fee is too high, you don't use the card, bad customer service, whatever. I mean, people can pick and choose to use whatever credit products they want to use. But at the very least, you should be cognizant of the potential downside of closing credit card accounts. So one of the ways that credit card accounts, especially the ones that are unused, that don't have a balance, helps your credit score is because of the unused credit limit, okay? There is a measurement in credit scoring systems called revolving utilization, or some people call it the credit utilization ratio or the balance to limit ratio. It's not really those other things. It's really called revolving utilization. And essentially what it is, it's the relationship between the balances on credit cards, not HELOCs, credit cards, to the credit limits on the credit report. And so if you have a, you know, $1,000 worth of balances on your credit report and $10,000 of credit limits on your credit reports, then you're using 10% of your limits. And so you have a 10% revolving utilization ratio. The lower that percentage, the better it's going to be for your credit score, generally speaking. So you want to keep that percentage as low as possible. And one of the ways to do it is to not close unused credit card accounts, because you actually continue to get the value of the credit limit on the card, even if it's on your credit report, but you're not actually using it. So as long as it's still open, meaning it's not reporting as being closed, then you get the value of the unused limit. But the minute you close it, and your credit report is updated to indicate that the account has been closed, you're gonna lose the value of the credit limit immediately. And so even if you do nothing other than close that card, your revolving utilization ratio is going to go up. It has to, it's a mathematical certainty, because you've just removed some amount of your aggregate credit limit. So you have to pay down the balance an equal amount in order for that ratio to not go up. So you actually might lower your credit score when you do close credit card accounts. Again, you know, you're all adults. You can pick and choose to open accounts, close accounts when you want. But if you're going to close a credit card account, then fine. Just don't do it right before you go apply for a mortgage or a car loan, where every basis point of your interest rate is meaningful every single month because the amount that you're borrowing is so large. So if you're going to close a credit card account, do it, you know, 6 months before you plan on applying for something, or years before you plan on applying for something. And then you can see what kind of damage you've done to your credit score, if any. And then of course you can react accordingly and help to kind of correct any problems that you've caused. So one of the myths that you commonly see in the blogosphere about closing credit cards, you see a lot of finance bloggers write articles telling consumers, if you're gonna close a credit card, don't close your oldest card, close a newer card. So if you close your oldest card, you're gonna hurt your credit score. That's incorrect. What they're insinuating is that when you close a credit card, that you're gonna lose the value of the age of the card in your credit score. That is a myth, that is untrue. As long as the account is still on your credit report, then you still get the value of the age of the card. So if you have a credit card that you've had for 10, 15 years and you close it, as long as it's still on the credit report, you still have a credit card on your credit report that's 10 or 15 years old. And in fact, it continues to age even if it's closed. So if you have a 10-year-old credit card and you closed it today, next year on the same exact date, you're gonna have an 11-year-old credit card. And the year after that, you'll have a 12-year-old credit card. So it doesn't matter if it's open or closed, it's still going to count the age of the account and it's still going to continue to age over time. So that is, in fact, a myth. But trust me, you're gonna find articles that suggest that this is an issue ad nauseum. And I can assure you that it is not. No, it is not. So if you're gonna close a credit card, it's really the credit limit that's the primary issue vis-a-vis your credit score. So let me give you something to consider as you're going through your wallet and deciding whether or not you wanna close credit cards. You hear a lot of people argue, well, you know, they could be fraudulently used if I don't close them. That's absolutely true. They absolutely can be fraudulently used. But because of the Fair Credit Billing Act, or the FCBA, you have $50 of liability maximum for fraudulent credit card use. And the four credit card networks, Amex, Discover, Visa, MasterCard, all have zero liability policies. And so as long as you report the fact that you've been the victim of credit card fraud, you're not gonna have to pay a dime. So even though, yes, it's something to be cognizant about, that you can be the victim of credit card fraud, it's never gonna cause you to have to pay anything out of your wallet as long as you report the fact that you've been defrauded. So I get the idea of being worried about fraud, but you really have no issues there as far as liability for money goes. The other one that I hear quite often, and it's a valid argument, is, well, I don't have enough self-control to not use it. It's almost like putting a piece of cake in front of me. I'm gonna eat it. I'd rather you not put it in front of me because then I know it's not there. But if you put it in front of me, I'm gonna eat it. It's the same thing with credit cards. Some people, if they have a credit card on their wallet, they can't control themselves. They're going to use it and they're gonna get into debt. So for them, it's easier just to close it and be done with it. Entirely valid position and argument. If you wanna close it because of that, then close it. But you can accomplish the same thing by just taking the card and running it through the shredder. You don't have the card number memorized. No one has their card numbers memorized. The card is physically gone, doesn't exist any longer. So it's gonna be really hard for you to use and abuse the card when it doesn't even exist. And of course, if someday you want to use that card again, you can call the issuer and they'll send you a replacement credit card. So, you know, just some counter arguments to some of the common arguments you hear about, you know, why you should close credit cards, notwithstanding the issue that it can cause your credit score. So if you have any questions, drop them in the section below and I'll do my best to answer them. Thanks for watching. Have a great rest of your day. We'll talk again soon.
For more videos and credit tips from John Olsheimer, go to www.tradelinesupply.com.